संजीव सुरेंद्र कपूर पाक कला।
Welcome to Chai with Manju. Our special guest today has been named as the top 5 celebrity chefs in the world by CNN. His show Khana Khazana is the longest running show in Indian television history. Let us meet Master Chef Padma Shri Sanjeev Kapoor. Sanjeev ji, namaste.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Welcome to Boston.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for coming on the show. And thank you for being part of Akshay Patra. I don't think it could be anything better than the most famous chef in India supporting a cause that is food for education for kids. So tell us, how did you get involved with Akshay Patra?
Oh, off and on, I've been involved with Akshay Patra through different partners and all.
Okay.
So I believe that what Akshay Patra has been doing over the years, each year they've been growing strength to strength, and the numbers that they have achieved are staggering. It's something which nowhere in the world you see this kind of an effort. And I realize that food has given me everything. Whatever I am today is thanks to power of food. So since I've got so much from food, it's my turn to now give back through food. And there's no better partner than Akshay Patra to do that.
Absolutely. Now, your journey has been very interesting. For somebody I was reading who did not know who a chef was and had not been to a big restaurant, you kind of fell into it a little bit accidentally, right? Mm-hmm. I was reading one of your friends, Jasmeet Singh or Sami, you wanted to be an architect. And he actually sent in your application for hotel management, right?
That's right.
And the rest is history. So share that story with our viewers, please.
Actually, I didn't know who a chef was. I just wanted to do something which was different. And this friend of mine, he wanted to be in this industry. And since we used to study together post school and all, so he just filled my application also. I didn't know that this is something which would interest me. I was more into engineering, architecture, that kind of field.
Typical Indian professions, right?
Yeah, because if you were good in studies, then it was expected that this is either doctor ban jaoge or engineer ban jaoge. That's
math mein ho to engineer,
biology mein ho to doctor. So I was very good with maths. So
you were the top 5 students in your class. Oh,
yeah.
That's right.
So because of that was predicted.
Uh-huh.
But when that happened, I said, okay, mm-hmm. no, this is something different. Maybe I should try my hand at that. And I have always done things which are not predictable. I've always done things which others have not done. So I guess my willingness, or you could call courage, to stand out has helped me to become outstanding in this field.
Absolutely. And when I listen to all your interviews, I think the one word that comes across always is you say you want to be different.
That's correct.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, you're one of those people, actually I should say you are the first person who made this career kind of a mainstream career in India, especially, made it very acceptable. People could follow their dreams. There was one story that I found very striking, actually, really touched my heart. In one interview you said that you as a chef were in the lobby of the hotel,
mm-hmm.
and the hotel manager asked you actually to go back to the kitchen.
Yes.
And how did that impact you? Did it impact you
big way.
Any
big way?
Yeah.
Because I thought that why should this kind of discrimination should be there?
Uh-huh.
I felt that it was unfair.
Uh-huh.
And I was doing things in a very logical way.
Mm-hmm.
I went to the lobby to meet the tour leader who was checking in,
uh-huh.
to ask what their food preference mm-hmm. Would be. Mm-hmm. And to me, it was a very logical thing to ask. Kya acha lagta hai aapko ye? So it was something which, when the GM said that to me, I said, this is mm-hmm. not acceptable. And I think back of my mind, I made that promise to myself that I have to change this.
And you did.
I have to change this. That this is not just you are in the back of the house. So after that, any given opportunity, I kept on fighting. I kept on doing things my way. And today, I feel delighted when I see you going to restaurants and chefs are all over and chefs are moving across and I smile. I say, okay.
वो भी दिन थे. कभी आपकी वो general manager से मुलाकात हुई वापस?
वो अभी भी touch में हूँ.
कभी उन्होंने आपको कुछ बोला?
नहीं, वो हम बात नहीं करते. ना मैं ये बताता हूँ किसने कहा था.
That's okay. Now, you were also named the best executive chef at the age of 28, right? Mm-hmm. That was something very different those days.
Yeah, it was. It was quite rewarding because to get that kind of recognition was thrilling. But at the same time, that put a lot of pressure on me because I realized that I have got all this at such a young age. Mm-hmm. So what bothered me then was that now what would I do now? Mm-hmm. Because if I have achieved peak literally of my career at 28, then what would I do? So but that helped me because then I studied more. I went to a marketing course.
That has helped you a lot.
I'm a student of life. I'm always learning. Right. There's not a day that I don't learn.
Absolutely.
And I say this all the time that to me, the day I stop learning should be my last day of life.
And you always say, I saw in your interviews, the best way to learn is to teach.
That's right. Because after you have taught, you realize, oh, you have nothing. So you have to again know more. So teaching is the best learning.
So I have to talk about Khana Khazana. Mm-hmm. I think you've had over 500 million views and the longest running show. I think anybody you talk to in India has memories of Khana Khazana. Hamare ghar mein to everything, my mom's whole schedule was around Khana Khazana. My dad used to actually object to that.
Right.
But Sanjeev ji jayenge, uske baad khana banega. So what do you have any special memories of Khana Khazana?
Tons of it.
It was almost called Shriman Bavarchi, I heard.
Yes, it wasn't called Khana Khazana to begin with.
That's such a horrible name, Shriman Bavarchi.
And when I suggested, I said, no, I will not do the show because I don't like the name. Mm-hmm. Because remember, I was at that time, I was trying to fight this thing, and I was trying to get more respect for chefs.
Mindset.
Yeah, imagine when somebody says, why are you in the lobby of a hotel, and chef is somebody who's a Maharaj Bavarchi. So I'm trying to bring respectability to the profession, and you have a show which is titled Shriman Bavarchi. I said, nah, I don't want to do it. Saying no to TV was such a big thing. Everyone said, are you mad? Uh-huh. You're getting this opportunity. I said, no, I'm sure what I'm doing. So that was good fun because I stood by what I felt. And luckily at that time, the producer director of the show, who's a big filmmaker now, he believed in me. Uh-huh. And he and I actually met last month, Hansal Mehta. Hansal, big filmmaker, so he's a big foodie, and we've
very few Indians are not foodies.
Yeah, that is true. No, but Hansal,
especially Gujaratis.
Yeah, Hansal is a Gujarati. Yes, Hansal is somebody who not only believed in me, he believed in the power of food, and I think together we created something which is legendary. I kept on doing this show for 19 years, actually non-stop, and till I started my own TV channel, Food, and now Food. It's It's been close to 7 years now.
You're quite an entrepreneur, right? Mm-hmm. You have the restaurant chain, I think, now in 43 different countries. It's called Yellow Chili's, right?
Yeah, we have different brands. Yellow Chili is our casual dining brand. We have Signature by Sanjeev Kapoor. We have Khazana. We have Hong Kong. We have Suravi. So there are different brands that we have.
And then the books.
Yeah.
200 books, I think, right?
Something like that. But then, yeah, we also have a company of cookware, Wonder Chef. Yes.
And that is expanding in these countries, in our United States and all that too.
Yeah, so there are certain things, restaurants, TV channel, of course, food is seen all across here. And we have fairly large digital presence, one of the early adopters of technology. When people didn't know what a website was, sanjeevkapoor.com was up and running. I say this in India that when Times of India didn't have a website, Sanjeev Kapoor did.
What drives you, you think? Like, were you always like that as a child?
I'm very restless. Yeah, I'm right. Very restless kind of person.
You're an Aries.
I'm Aries. I'm a typical Aries. Fire sign. Yeah.
Now, interestingly, for a man who did not know what a chef was, now you're not only the most renowned chef in India, but recently you were also flown specially to Abu Dhabi to have a special meal for Prime Minister Modi. So what was that experience like?
Oh, very good. Actually, catering for VVIPs is nothing new to me. I've done it many times over in my initial career. But I think Prime Minister Modi, he as a person, as a personality, as a leader, it was a big honor. And what was good was that I was flown all the way by the rulers of UAE, not by Indian government, by rulers of UAE to cater for Prime Minister's visit. And so Prime Minister did not know that I'll be there. Indian team did not know that I'll be there. And when they reached there, we had done our preparation, and there's somebody who came and, PM is not going to eat, he's on a fast. I had traveled all the distance, we had made all these arrangements, and he's not going to eat because he's on fast, so we're not. So we were struggling with, now what? Whatever. It's what it is. But within half an hour, get the message, tell Chef Kapoor that I'm going to make an exception. I will eat because he's there. So that's something which is so nice. And it was and the warmth that he has. And of course, everyone loved the food and everything. Discussion.
What did you make for him?
Oh, many things.
What did he like the most?
The thing was that it was quite an eventful. There was only 12 people that we were catering to, but it went through last minute, so many changes. So suddenly we had to do dishes which were good for fast. So we had not planned that, but last minute we did that in a country where
non-veg is the way to go, right?
And all others, the rulers in UAE and all, they were eating non-vegetarian, so we were only doing vegetarian for Prime Minister. So last minute, not only did we have that, food for fasting for him, then everyone else changed to vegetarian food last minute. That Indian Prime Minister is vegetarian, so we will also eat vegetarian food today. Yeah, fine, it's all good for you, but
how much food you have to cook?
So, but it was good. It was very, very good. Went on very well. And since that dinner, and I had only gone for that, that dinner went on very well. And Prime Minister was there next day for breakfast also. So now the Indian contingent, everyone came to me. Now you take care of his breakfast also. We don't want to make any regular. You are there, you do that. I said, but we have not planned it. He said, okay, don't worry, we'll do something. So we made few things, lots of Indian things, lots of local dishes also. So in the morning, they said, so what is there? I said, we have done many things. So go and ask what he wants, and we would have. Nobody wanted to go and ask. So I was saying, Chef, please. But and they had seen at dinner time, they had seen the warmth that he had and the way he met me and all everything. So I said, okay. So I went there and I was so lucky that not only he had literally everything that we had done.
He tasted.
Okay. So, of course, we had from parathas to idli to dosa to everything Indian vegetarian. But at the same time, we had done lots of local Emirati food, it's called. So I asked him, I said, sir, would you like to try something local? Oh, bilkul try karenge. Culture kisi jagah ka pata karne ke liye khana sabse badi cheez hoti hai.
That is your trademark too. You always try local flavors,
right? That's
right,
always.
Right.
So, while doing that, I got the opportunity of spending a lot of time with him, one-on-one, 45 minutes, and discussed things which I don't think even very senior ministers would have got that chance to. So a very great session, 45 minutes on food and health and yoga and religion and I don't know, everything that was there. And so very great experience.
Special memories, right?
Special memories and great thing is that so recently this month when the Padma Shri was given, so he was of course he was there, and again same warmth and always. So if whenever I've met him, wonderful. And see, I can see that the way India is changing, people, the confidence of the world in
absolutely,
India.
Absolutely.
Our stock market is at all-time high.
Right.
So that's the confidence that
the country is getting cleaner.
Everything.
In many different ways.
Remarkable.
Now shifting gears a little bit, we just for our viewers, we want to share a little bit about your family. Mm-hmm. Your wife is Alena. She's Gujarati. Right?
Yes.
And she's been your partner, right? Mm-hmm. And then you have two daughters, right?
Yes.
Ruchita and Kriti.
That's correct.
Okay. And you're a very hands-on, very close-knit family.
I believe that that's something which in Indian society we are so lucky that we have those values. So if we have that, then why not enjoy it?
Some of the things that I like about your life is the things that you do often together with the family or for the family. I watched your Jhalak Dikhla Ja. And I remember you said that you learned to dance because of your wife.
That is correct.
Right?
That is correct. I couldn't learn that much, but that's okay.
You did good. You got pretty high up
there.
Yeah,
I did. Right? I think that was because of words, not because of dancing.
I think whatever you do, you really put your heart into it, right?
I do, yes.
And you started running because of your daughter, because she's an athlete?
She is. She's an athlete, yes.
So as a doctor, I have to ask you, aapki sehat ka raaz kya hai?
Apna banaya hua khana khata. No, I think in today's day and age, there's no other way. It's pehle jab bachpan mein train mein travel karte the, to ek line likhi hoti thi, sawari apne saman ke khud zimmedar hai. So insaan apne shareer ka khud zimmedar hai. Yeah, so nobody else, you can wake up in the morning, jao hamare liye walk karke aao, khud hi jana padega.
पर आप इतना ट्रैवल करते हो तो आप कैसे मैनेज करते
हो? I think so. Last evening we arrived in Boston, right? So we had to go out for dinner. So we said no, okay, let's walk. And so this morning for breakfast, so we're meeting somebody, and I said, oh, that's only 18 minutes walk. So you do that and you realize that so by this time, half day, but I probably would have done close to about 8 to 10 kilometers.
Really?
Yeah. So it's not even exercise.
Uh-huh.
But you try and do things.
Lekin aap khate kya?
Sab kuch khata. Okay.
You're mostly vegetarian, little bit non-vegetarian.
Yeah, I eat everything, but I say I'm a vegetarian at heart.
Now, if you could invite one guest for dinner, who would that be? or maybe your top five guests if you don't want to pick one.
No, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, तो एक भी कर सकता हूँ, एक एक करके बात कुछ. आई थिंक सो आई हैव पहले एक चीज बताता हूँ दैट there are many interviews that I go through many times and but I really like that you have done a lot of work, a lot of research. Very, very happy. Because I feel ki aap interview ke liye baithte ho and then you're asked, tell us about yourself. How did you start? I said, everything is there to ask. So I'm very happy. So must compliment you,
you
for
so
that.
Much.
Really, really, really good.
So
and so. So I've often said this, there are two people that I like to call, and one would be Charlie Chaplin, second would be Mahatma Gandhi.
Very nice.
So reason, I'll tell you. One is Charlie Chaplin, what do you give a person? Because no matter what you give, उन्होंने तो आपके खाने का मजाक ही उड़ाना है. So how do you please someone who is so difficult to please in that sense? So according to me, he's a difficult customer.
And you like a challenge.
Yeah, I like a challenge. And second person who is so simple as Mahatma Gandhi. What do you cook for somebody who's so simple? You want to do something special for a special person, but special things are not what he wants. So would you do something which is boring? No. So these two people, I think, difficult challenge.
वैसे कहीं मैंने पढ़ा था आपको आमिर खान को भी खाना खिलाना.
हाँ नहीं, आमिर खान तो खैर
अब आप खिला चुके हैं.
नहीं, आमिर खान तो खैर
बाहर, वो 5 साल पहले की बात थी. So now, what do you see is the future? What are your future plans, and what do you see the impact of Indian food globally?
Right. So my future plan is to raise as much money for Akshay Patra as possible.
Today, of course.
Yes.
So my shakar.
Yeah. So mera future aise hi hota hai, kuch ghanton ka hota hai. I don't think he. So I take one day at a time. I believe that that's the most important thing to do. And in terms of Indian food, good thing is that Indian food has started to get that kind of respect. Jo पहले नहीं थी, पहले नहीं थी. Now we are seeing that respect, and I'm sure I was telling a friend who would come from New York today. I said, I think now is the time when Indian food will start to take global center stage. It will play a role of dominance in next 10 years, and you will see that Indian food will become in some sense center of the plate for the world.
Timing is everything.
Yeah,
so lastly, आपसे quickly rapid response. अब आपसे तो पूछना है, just whatever comes to your mind. आपका favorite, what is your favorite food?
चाट. गोलगप्पे.
और आपको पंजाबी कढ़ी भी बहुत पसंद है.
पंजाबी कढ़ी बहुत पसंद है आपको.
And your favorite hobby?
Favorite hobby, in music now. ट्रम्पेट हो किसी एड में वैसे ही दिखा था, बट आई प्ले प्रकाशन्स. आई रिमेम्बर आपने भी शंकर महादेवन को इंटरव्यू किया. सो इज अ वेरी गुड फ्रेंड दैट शंकर मेट अबाउट 3-4 डेज अगो. फनी दैट इफ ही वाज नॉट अ सिंगर ही वुड बी अ शेफ. वो खाना बनाना बड़ा अच्छा,
खाना बनाने का बहुत बहुत रिलैक्सिंग
लगता है. And उसी तरह से मुझे म्यूजिक बहुत रिलैक्सिंग लगता है. सो माय ऑफिस रूम, इट डज नॉट लुक लाइक अ शेफ्स रूम, इट लुक्स लाइक अ म्यूजिशियंस रूम. देयर इज अ बिग ड्रम किट, देयर इज अ गिटार, देयर इज अ कीबोर्ड, देयर आर स्पीकर्स, देयर आर माइक्स. लुक्स लाइक अ म्यूजिशियंस रूम.
क्या बात है. आपकी फेवरेट स्पाइस क्या है?
मेरे फेवरेट स्पाइस नमक है.
स्वाद अनुसार उसके बिना तो, इसीलिए तो गुजराती में उसको मीठू कहते हैं. अच्छा ये बताइए, आपकी सबसे बड़ी स्ट्रेंथ क्या है?
एक्चुअली मेरी सबसे बड़ी स्ट्रेंथ ये है कि मुझे पता ही नहीं है कि मेरी सबसे बड़ी स्ट्रेंथ क्या है. सो आई एम ऑलवेज ट्राइंग टू वर्क ऑन इम्प्रूविंग माय सेल्फ.
परमानेंट स्टूडेंट.
सो आई ऑलवेज थिंक that I am work in progress. अभी तो ये करना है, अभी तो ये करना है, अभी तो करना है.
और आपकी weakness?
Weakness बहुत सारी हैं. Weakness तो
something you want to fix?
Oh, hundreds of things. बहुत सारी. I want to learn how to cook good food.
वो तो कोई नहीं मान सकता.
Because I believe that there is so much to learn, so that's it.
And you're quite one thing I read. You आपको gadgets बहुत पसंद हैं, gadgets और gizmos. आपका सबसे favorite gadget क्या है?
Oh. मतलब आजकल तो वो जो ड्रोन्स आते हैं ना.
Now which is one thing that you can't be without?
My family.
Okay. Well, thank you so much. ये आपने हमारी जिंदगी को बहुत स्पाइसी बनाया है, बहुत टेस्टी बनाया है. And we wish you all the best. Thank you so much for coming to Boston and Japan.
Thank you very much. Thank you.